Hey, this is Julie, here to teach you No One by Alicia Keys. I taught this song to a friend who didn't know a lick of piano, and we put on a little performance for his family as I sang and he played, and they were blown away. Not by my voice, but by his playing. Let's let you do the same thing. We're going to be learning four chords, and these chords are E, B6, C sharp minor 7, and A. Those four chords, repeated over and over again, are going to take you through the verse, the pre-chorus, and the chorus of this song. Thank you, Alicia, for making a beautiful song very simple to play and very easy to remember. So we're going to start off with the left hand, because let's just get this very, very simple thing out of the way. Most of the time, the bass note or the bottom note of the chord is going to be the name of the chord. So we have an E chord, which means we want to play an E as our bass note. When we change chords and we go to the B6, we want to play a B. And we change chords to the C sharp minor 7, we want to play C sharp. And then down to the A. And for the left hand, it may seem simple, and that's because it is. You're just going to be playing one note in the left hand each time you switch chords. So get used to playing those notes in that order, and you'll be done with the left hand. With the right hand, let's do the E with the right hand. Really what it is it's a familiar right hand of the spread position in the professional chord system. And since we want to play a special rhythm pattern that Alicia has for us, we're going to play one of these notes twice. And that's going to be the B. So we're going to hit another B right there at the top. So listen to this rhythm pattern. Right? Sounds complicated. No, just because it sounds good doesn't mean it's complicated, and it doesn't mean that you can't do it. Just break it down slowly, and just know you're going to go from the bottom up three notes, and then go back one note, and then start at the top and just ascend down. Notice that once I've hit that first note and I start to climb to the top, I let go of the first note because it's hard to reach both notes at the same time. I can actually reach it, but don't count yourself out if you have smaller hands. You can just kind of roll. And you've got all of them. All right, the second chord is a B6. Let's find it by remembering the basic six note pattern in the professional chord system by David Higginson, which is. So drop the left hand, we just need the right hand here. And since we're playing a six, we need to add a six, B6. The third chord is the C sharp minor 7, and we're going to be playing the right hand of a basic five note pattern. And then we make it a minor and we add a 7. This chord, unlike the others, naturally has four separate notes, so we don't need to repeat any. And the final chord, an A, this is also from a basic five note pattern from the professional chord system, and that is to just play this and then add another A at the top. Now, something to do that will help when it comes to attaching these chords together in this chord chain is to notice the similarities in these chords. So if you're starting with the E, you'll notice that these two notes on the right stay with you for the first three chords. Then you change to and then down to the A. Let's see what it sounds like with both the left and the right hand together. And you're just going to be playing the left hand note once and holding it down playing it at the same time as the first note of the right hand of the chord. So, see? And then on to the next. That's that.